why do a circle have 360 degrees? Kind of a weird that a circle have 360 degrees. At first thought, it seems like a random number. But why not it's 100 or 400? In gradient system of measuring an angle, a circle is divided into small 400 chunks and each chunk is called as one gradient. You might not have heard the term gradients because it is rarely used, but measurement of angles are done in many ways. The first one is degree system, second one is radian system, and third one is gradient system. The first reason behind the mystery of 360 is that this is not a random number. It is a special number. The great Indian scientist Ramanuj called these type of numbers as highly composite numbers. These type of numbers have lot of factors. These features make 360 a really convenient number. We can divide a circle into even parts. It makes solving problems by hand. The number 360 is not only a highly composite number, as it is only one of the only seven numbers, such that no number less than twice as much as more divisors. There are total of 24 divisors of 360. Also, it has 6 prime factorization. One more interesting thing about 360 is that it is the smallest natural number which is divisible by 1 to 10 except 7. It is really amazing. But the question does not end here, as one can also choose multiples of 360 in order to do more parts of the circle. Persians about 3000 years ago used calendars which contain 360 days. But as we all know that Earth takes 365 days and 6 hours to make a whole revolution around the sun. But we only take 365 days a year, and then we have a leap year in every 4 years. Similarly, instead of taking 365 days and 6 hours, they used only 360 days for simplicity, and then they have an extra month in every 6 years. That's not the end of the story. Babylonians about 400 more years ago used a base 60 number system called a sexagesimal system. We used 10 different symbols to represent numbers, they used 60. Interestingly, they also know about the equilateral triangles. If 6 of these triangles are arranged in certain ways, with the edge, so that a circle passes from the vertex to the triangles, then they decided an angle of an equilateral triangle be 60 degrees, and hence 60 into 6, 360 degrees. So, we have reasonable ideas about the origin of 360 degree convention. What about other system of measuring angles, and what about pi? Another system of measuring angles is called as radians. Before learning what is radian, we must know what is pi. Pi is the ratio of the diameter of the circle to its circumference, and it come out to be 3 and a bit more. So, radian is basically when we express angle as the perimeter of a circle. Look at these steps carefully. One radian is equal to 57.296 degrees. One radian is said when the circle of radius r makes a segment of a perimeter equals to its radius. Thus, for every circle, one radian is always same. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe for more cool stuff, and a happy